لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سوى.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ونصلي ونسلم على خير خلق الله محمد بن عبد الله، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, respective viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to our program. First of all, we congratulate all our brothers and sisters by the coming month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a blessing Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your ibadah in the month of Ramadan. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us tawbah before the coming of Ramadan, inshallah. Once again, we say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يبارك لنا في شعبان ويبلغنا رمضان إن شاء الله. Many of our brothers, they asking and sending SMSs and emails and phone calls regarding zakat and sadaqat. And I know every Muslim brother now talking about zakat and sadaqat, to take some zakat or to give some zakat. So Muslim between ni'mat and some difficulties and some problem. My message today for those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them a ni'mat of money, and now they confuse what should they do with the money. We know that zakat is haqq of Allah, wa fi amwalihim haqqun lis-sa'il wal-mar, haqqun ma'lum, is a fixed amount, and it is a property of Allah and the money of Allah. So there is no man on earth can suggest what should we do with the money of Allah except Allah himself. That's why the word zakat came in Quran after salat immediately, because salat got zakat and zakat got salat itself. الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة. You find zakat and salat together. فرض of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must upon the Muslim if he got the nisab of zakat. To know the nisab of zakat, you have to sit with the mufti and you must tell him about your business, your activities, your property, your money, your farm, your cattle, your animals, any type of activities you're doing it to gain money and to make that money from. If you are involved in business, you got certain rules. You're involved in farming and crops, animals, any type of that activities which you made money from. So we cannot roll it on a program, on a TV program, because it's very serious how much a fixed amount you give out of your personal amount, which that money, how you calculate your zakat, how you make all that rules of zakat. Because there is a bab in the Kitab al-Hadith, it's called the Bab al-Zakat and Bab al-Sadaqat. Today I'm directing my talk to our wealthy brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant Muslim brothers who are wealthy and rich ni'mat of money, and may Allah make it easy for them to give and fulfill the right of this amanat before they close their eyes and they die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise Ahlul Iman and praise the people who pay zakat. And أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله. Those who spend their wealth for the sake of Allah. ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا. Then they don't follow what they spend. من ولا أذى. With no favor or without harming. لهم أجرهم عند ربهم. They will be rewarded in the day of Allah, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا خوف عليهم. No fear on them in the time of death. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They will have no grief that they are leaving this dunya in the time of death. So no fear, no grief, and no sadness. My message today for those who want to do their zakat properly. after you go to the mufti or to the alim or the imam to know how much money you have and how you spend it, when did you start the money, when did the nisab is there. If you have gold, you have silver, you have farms, animals, you have to know how much zakat you have to take it out from. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you how you spend that zakat and to whom you give that zakat. Our duty today as a da'wah program, I have to show you whom must we give zakat to. Make sure that your money is halal. Make sure your business is halal, because إِنَّ اللَّهَ طَيِّبٌ لَا يَقْبَلُ إِلَّا طَيِّبًا. Indeed, Allah is pure and He does not accept anything which is impure. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise Ahlul Zakat, those who pay Zakat are the hands of Allah, are the wakils of Allah or the deputy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on His amanat. But don't forget, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu set up a war and jihad against those who refuse to give zakat. After Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, many people, they want to run away from that zakat, that haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know some people don't want to read salah, some people don't want to fast Ramadan, don't want to go for hajj. Sahaba, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not fight with them. Only Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he was ready to die to bring back this ibadah or that farad of Allah to action or to implement this one, because really, if the people stop paying zakat, it's going to be a disaster. A disaster in a Muslim life, in dunya and akhirah. That's why we learn now how serious was that matter in the eyes of the Sahaba and in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Farad of Allah, haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, my humble advice to my brother and sister, do not play with your zakat, do not cheat with your zakat, because it is a hisab and kitab in the day of Qiyamah, in the time of Sakaratul Maut. When we talk about zakat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about it as a sadaqah as well. Zakat is sadaqat, but sadaqat is not zakat. We have to learn this one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set up 8 ways to give you zakat, and make sure that your zakat is there in the pocket of the person who deserves it. Make sure you cannot allow to dump your money somewhere, or you just throw it like that and you run away. You have to make sure that you fulfill the amanat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran Kareem, innama sadaqat, he meant zakat. Zakat, lil fuqara. The first group of people who deserve zakat, those who are faqir, those who are poor. Those who are poor. How you know that person is faqir, as Quran Kareem describes him? He does not have 3 meals a day for him and for his children. So the faqir, the poor person, the one who does not have food, 3 meals a day, and we know that the 2/3 of Muslim ummah, they have empty stomach. Starvation in Africa, some Asian, they have that type of faqr and that type of poverty of the stomach, which really, this ju'ah, that hunger, it's kufr, and we are responsible to fill the stomach of the hungry, and that is the first group of people of zakat, al-fuqara. So faqir is the one who does not have, unable to work for 3 meals a day. And we got plenty like that. Second one, والمساكين. مساكين, those who got 3 meals a day, they can eat 3 meals a day, but nothing else. And they don't ask. They call it سكنت نفسه عن السؤال. His soul and his dignity does not allow him to beg, which there are so many. Someone working, just working for his stomach. Just work to feed his family and children. He is miskin, he is a needy to Allah, as all of us we know that we are needy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So miskin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about miskin. فَأَمَّا السَّفِينَةُ فَكَانَتْ لِمَسَاكِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ فِي الْبَحْرِ. Miskin had a ship, a ferry for renting, but maybe the business is down. Maybe they don't have enough income, so the masakin, someone got a truck, car, taxi, but doesn't work or doesn't have enough to survive. That is a miskin. The third one, والعاملين عليها. Those who are running the zakat, and I won't talk about it now because it's a very serious issue. Some people are cheating and taking a lot of money from the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it easy for them to stay away from the haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who are running and managing zakat money. Very serious issue, and we have to leave it today because we're going to make a special program about that. Some people, they just use the zakat, they misuse the zakat, they don't know how they deal with that zakat, and they survive by this zakat, which is a very serious issue. The next one, وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةُ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Those, we raise hope for them to accept Islam. Like here in Africa, in some non-Muslim country, we find the chief of the tribe, we find some Muslim, they can help us, they can make it easy for masajid. It's not a bribery. It's not a bribery because one of our friends, he was thinking, is a no. That is hadiya. We count it as a hadiya. We stimulate his heart to join Islam and to accept Islam. The number next, wa fil riqab, those who are in the prison, the prisoners and their family. They call them fil riqab. So when we say prisoners, his children are not criminal. His wife is not criminal. So we say maybe someone owe people money, someone got problem in his business, the government lock him up because of his political opinion, because of his Islamic point of view. You got plenty Muslims in a jail, unfair imprisonment, unfair. And we do a prison program here in South Africa, and we find some Muslims really, they enter and spend so many years in a prison innocently. We call them Yusuf alayhi salam. So what we say, these people are fir riqab, and you got plenty of people enter the jail because of innocent charge or because something they don't mean to do it. Brother and sister in Islam, it's very serious issue, zakat, and I can see my cameraman ask me to stop for a break. Inshallah, I'll continue after the break.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. We'd like to thank all our viewers who are joining us now. Shukran jazilan that you are watching our show. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of you, inshallah. Today we're talking about the issue of zakat. And I know many Muslims, they want to know more about zakat. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to take that issue of zakat as a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to look after that command of Allah and fulfill that command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before the break, we're talking about those who deserve to receive zakat. And so, as I said before the break, that we have to make sure that we are giving the right zakat to the right person, because it's the haqq of Allah. If we give the zakat to the wrong person, we deprive those who deserve that zakat. And if someone, a wrong person, took the zakat in a wrong way, he deprived also many poor people and sometimes kill many people because of hunger and starvation. If that person does not deserve zakat, he is already participating in a murder and the killing of some people because they're supposed to go for someone else, and he deprived the one who deserved that zakat. Before the break, I was talking about for fir riqab, those who are in the prison, those who went or they entered the prison because of shari'i things, or as I said, the family of the prisoner, they deserve that type of zakat. As we said, he was guaranteed someone, or he was involved on some political issue or some dini issue, and the kuffar lock him up and all these things. Well, gharimin, those who owe people money. Gharimin is those who are in debt. And we look at the Muslim nowadays, they put themselves on debt for nothing. They have a big want, not a big need. When we say big want, it means he go and buy the TV, a new furniture, building a house, renovating a house, and say, I'm in debt. That is not a debt. We're talking about a real qard or the real gharimin, those who found themselves unintentionally in debt. For example, the person who guaranteed the Muslims, Many people, they are working on the government offices, or they have property and what. And then someone come to them and say, can you guarantee me for this or that? And then he found himself, that person ran away here or there, and he found himself on debt. Another one, his business collapsed, and he could not have that sufficient amount to pay and all debt. That issue of debt or that dain, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam refused to make salatul janazah on such person like that. So it's very important to free him from the adab of Allah, because he's a worse mayyit, even if he's shaheed. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah will forgive everything for the shaheed except the dain. So we have to make sure that we free the Muslim. And I think this is the greatest sadaqah and zakat, when you free the person from the shame here and disgrace here, and also the adab of Allah in the day of Qiyamah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never interfere on that type of sin in the day of Qiyamah. And then the next one is called wafi sabilillah. Sabilillah, for the sake of Allah. That one also, as we left, that one is called working on zakat. Those who are managing zakat will live for sabilillah, because there's no fixed meaning for that, or a certain words for that. Sabilillah, for the sake of Allah, for the path of Allah. Some of the mufassirin said is jihad or education, Islamic education, like hifz al-Quran and all that. And some of the mufassirin said, no, it's more than that. Anything good is fi sabilillah. So inshallah, we'll make a special program for that one. It's called fi sabilillahi wasi'ah. It's very wide and very huge. The other thing is called wabn al-sabil. And the one who is in the path of Allah. Wabn al-sabil, the stranger, or those who narrowed. Wabn al-sabil. The ulama said, the one who really needs your zakat is those who are traveler, those who have been cut and disconnected between them and their wealth and money. Someone from overseas doesn't have his money here, he needs help, so we have to assist him. Some people said, even if they are non-Muslim, because وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرْهُ. If a person, mushrik, ask you for help and to seek shelter by you, so you have to assist him. And he used to assist him from Baytul Mal. Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu an gave the Yahudi money from Baytul Mal to pay his jizya or his tax. Faridatum min Allah. It is a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah said that zakat, make sure that person will be rich after that. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ignuhum an al-su'al fi hadha al-yawm." So he said, give him the spending, the amount of the full year for food, clothes, maskan, house. So housing, food, and clothes. So make sure that that person won't cry for food, for full year, and for living, or for maskan, and for clothes. As I said, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu an did make war between him, Muslims, and those who refused to pay zakat, because they became murtad. They call them murtad. So make sure that you are keen to give your zakat. When we talk about the needy, now we finished that 8 people who deserve our zakat. Make sure that you are not wali of these people, because you cannot give zakat to your mother, your father, your daughter, your son, because you are a responsible person to feed them. That's why we have to be very sure that we are not giving those who are under our responsibility, or that it's a must upon us to feed them and to look after them. Your daughter, your son, your mother, your father, these people, we give them sadaqat, but we don't give them our zakat. Now we'll leave zakat now, because this is a haqq of Allah, this is a right of Allah. We call it taqwa ijbariya, is a forced taqwa, you can't run away from it. It is a command of Allah, it's a money of Allah. What about your money? We call it maqam al-ihsan. Many of ulama, they said for the rich person, regarding the hungry people, even after you give your zakat, and if you know that someone is hungry and someone does not have a food, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question you about that type of sadaqah. It's equal to zakat. You have to go and feed them. If you cannot go to your bed and sleep while you know your next door, your neighbor is hungry, and you did not go and feed them. And we do know many people hungry, and we don't want to go and give them. The first group of people who deserve sadaqat, you know, after you pay your zakat, we'll go for sadaqat now. Sadaqat is called Ahlul Ihsan. You elevate yourself to a high level. Innahum kanu qabla dhalika muhsineen. Indeed, they were before that a very, in al muttaqina fi jannatin wa uyun. They have a high status in Jannah and fountain and spring. Why? Because innahum kanu qabla dhalika muhsineen. Indeed, they were before that from Ahlul Ihsan, those who give more than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give. Like in this Mubarak month of Sha'ban and Ramadan, we have to give sadaqat, because sadaqah in a month of Ramadan, it will be counted as a zakat itself. The first group of people who deserve our sadaqat, someone is called al-malhuf, the really the desperate one, the one who is really desperate. Someone need to pay a certain amount, someone in a big trouble, in a disaster, run to malhuf and assess the malhuf. And we do have a hero of the Muslims. They run and assess. They don't think. They say, malhuf, you just give him without asking. Someone in accident, someone got janaza, someone got problem, he must pay now. So you run and tell him, take for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That could be a loan, or it could be also sadaqat. The other one, we call him al-qani'. What is al-qani'? Many Muslims, they don't beg, and we should not beg, because Islam came to fight poverty and to stop Muslims from begging, even to get zakat and all that. But because we became very stingy, we're very hard now, they come and beg. So al-qani', some people look rich, very smart person, is working, but he needs help. Many of our family members and relatives, they look very rich because he's eating halal. He's instruct himself and his family to eat halal, so he's suffering, because nowadays halal is very hard, haram is very easy. So these people promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they will never eat haram. So he find him look very good, good looking, very clean. Don't ask. يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءُ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. This is al-qani'. He will eat grass and he will never come and ask you. These people, we have to go to them and give them our sadaqat with honor, and you will get reward, inshallah, for that. Another thing, it's called al-a'il, a family man. We call him the breadwinner of the family. Someone is working, and you got so many children, iyal, children, look after his father, mother, big family. That one year, he's the hand of Allah on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him a great reward with Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. He was like that. Also al-a'il, that person that we have a big families in the Muslim community, one man working and he look after his family, we have to support him. Another group of a'il, the one who spend his money for his children because of education, because of his generosity, because he's helping the Muslimin, and now he needs help, we have to go and support him before he regret to that he gave sadaqah or something like that. The other group, they call him al-mu'tar. What is al-mu'tar? Al-mu'tar, yeah, brother, the hungry person, the person who musafir, the person who is working for you, some people on the road, they're working, and we have to assess them. Because even some ulama put animal with that al-mu'tar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us believe on zakat, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to give sadaqat, inshallah. Again, my cameraman asked me to stop for a break. I will listen to him, and then we'll stop for a break. We'll continue after that, inshallah.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. We'd like to thank all our viewers for the emails and SMSs. شكرا جزيلا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to fulfill the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we're talking about the zakat, the charity, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us as a command, and He gave it to us as an option and a choice, and we reach the level of ihsan, inshallah. Why are we talking about this zakat? Because really, once the Muslim does not look after that command of Allah of zakat, Allah will stop the rain, and if the rain comes, it won't be beneficial rain, and we'll find the poverty amongst the Muslim, we'll find a very bad picture and very bad situation on the road when we see a Muslim brother begging a non-Muslim, or we find a Muslim country begging from a kuffar country. That is also unaccepted. Islam came to fight poverty. Islam came to give the Muslim honor. Even when he received his zakat, he also deserved that zakat with honor and respect, and he must receive it as his right and his haqq. Before the break, I was talking about those who deserve the sadaqat, or the help and the charity and the assist of us. And we, I think they're doing favor to us because they take our parcel to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will claim it inshallah in the day of Qiyamah. I was talking about that person who's al-mu'tar. Al-mu'tar, like those people who are selling on the road, someone working for you. I know you give him his wages, but he's hungry, so you give him, and that animal on the road and birds and all that, we call them mu'tar, the greatest sadaqah when you feed that type of hungry people or to fill that stomach of the animals. The other group of people deserve our sadaqat, the prisoner, al-asir, وَيَطْعُمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينَ وَيَتِيمَ وَأَسِيرَ. So they feed those who are prisoners. When we talk about the prisoners, we talk about the family of the prisoners. As I said before, when we go to the prison and see the people run to us and say, Sheikh, I didn't steal, I was innocent. We heard so many stories that because of the paper, because of the evidence, fake evidence, they came to the jail because some people, because of his Jum'ah talk, he was in the jail. And we find someone because he's in Islamic clothes. We find plenty cases like that, and we call him Yusuf alayhi salam. Now, that family of the prisoner, even if the prisoner is a criminal, but his children, his wife, his mother are not criminal, we have to go and assist them with sadaqat. And many family, like in Kashmir, Palestine, you got plenty family, they deserve our zakat and sadaqat, this asir, they call him asir. And then we have another group, it's called Aramil, Armala. You know the Armala, the widow. One woman like you, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant your husband long life, suddenly she receive a phone call that husband passed away, or sickness, or any type, because death is common. That lady, she's not used to work, even if she got money. She's not used to work. Life is very bad outside. It's a fight and jungle out there, and you find the man struggling to find a job. You think a woman can manage. So what we do, we go and assess the one who look after yatim. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about miskin and armala. If you look after the widow for the sake of Allah, you are the mujahid for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have a considerable armala, a widow, which the woman has a useless husband. Believe me, if you look at my emails and SMS, we have a plenty men, women are better than them. Why? Because you don't want to work. He's healthy and all. And many people say, no, she got a husband. He must go and work. You see, we cannot give penalty and punish the wife because of the action of the men. We have to go and assess this woman, and especially food, and look after the children. And we don't give that man money, but we give his wife and children for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have something, it's called a half a widow. Half a widow, well, the husband ran away, went for some other places, and he doesn't communicate with her, and we've got plenty cases like that. So we have to look that half a widow and considerable widow and a proper widow, mujahid for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other group of people also we have to assess them, we call them al-mahroom. Al-mahroom. وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. What is mahroom? You know, someone is working, but he wish to have something. He needs something, but he's working, he's okay. His salary is late. He got so many responsibility, and it's not enough. He wish to have something, but he doesn't have that means to have it. Some students needs to have kitab, needs to have computers to assist him like that. I know it's not food, but you have to do that one. We call him mahroom. Someone I know is eating bread and beans, and alhamdulillah is a ni'mat of Allah, but he wished to eat one meat. He want to have a chicken. He want to go for holiday. He want to just visit and to enjoy himself in halal way. We have to give him the sadaqah, and that is idkhal al-surur ala al-mu'min. We have some other group of people, call them khuddam, servant, the worker, the helper of us. How come the lady, you make braai and you eat meat, and you put the lady there on the corner there and you give her rice? They must eat from the same food you eat, and you have to give them sadaqat because you take that jealous and malice from those who are working for you. How come you're selling food, but you don't give him some sandwich from the company? You say, no, it's working. No, we have to let them taste that. How that lady is helping you in cooking, and she doesn't have any opportunity to take little bit for her children. We have to do that is the greatest sadaqah. We have to fill her eyes so that she must not be jealous, she must not steal, she must not try to hate you. The other group of people also, we call them al-marda. Al-marda is the ill people, sick people. We have to go and give sadaqat. Plenty Muslim in the hospital, public hospitals, they hate the food of the hospital. Because some hospital, they give a small, simple food, and these people need some medication from outside, they need some food, juice and all that. We have to go to the hospital, and the greatest ibadah, Allah will ask us about this Muslim who are lying there in the hospital, no one visit them, maybe they're from far or foreigner or something like that. The other group, which is very complicated, is called As-Sa'il, the beggars on the street. That one year, we made a special program for them. How to deal with the beggars in the stop and the traffic lights and the street and those who knock. We have to talk, but we give them, as we're going to talk about beggars in the street, because it's very complicated, it's very easy and very convenient job for the people nowadays, become a professional job. So how can we deal with that? Inshallah, we'll make a special program for that. The other group of people is called Al-Mu'asir. You know, Usr, Mu'asir. Someone is working, making money, but it was very difficult for him to make money. Someone bricks liar, that these people who are carrying, those people who working on the farm, those who working from Fajr time to Maghrib time, and for few, we call it pennies. They just take some food and cheap price like this, or small wages. This one we call him Mu'asir. Someone is traveling far, he's struggling and sweating a lot to collect his food. That one year we have to assist him. We cannot leave him like that. The other group of people, as you said, muhtaj. What is muhtaj? Needy. Someone admire something. That little girl, I know she want a doll or she want to play with a toy. Father can't buy for her that. There is a door of Jannah for those who make their children happy. So I know it is not a food and it's not necessary, but we have to make them. They call him muhtaj, needy. Someone want to marry. We have to assist him. Someone to want to buy shoes, nice shoes to go. Someone want to buy kitab. That I know is not food, but we have to assist him for that, and it's the greatest sadaqah. The other group of people also, we call them al-ba'is. What is al-ba'is? Al-ba'is, someone... He's not pretending. The person who's not pretending. What is the one who al-ba'is? You look at him, you will know by yourself that he's needy. He doesn't need to talk. The way he look, the way he talk, the way he love, we call him al-ba'is. Brother and sister in Islam, again, we're going to stop for a break. We'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program. And once again, on your behalf, I'd like to thank my cameraman and all our friends here in the studio. Shukran jazilan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of them, inshallah. Once again, we welcome you to our show. And shukran jazilan for your emails and SMSs. And today we're talking about those who are needy, those who need our support and our help, those who are powerless in our community. And all of us, we are needy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next, as I said, I was talking before the break about the ba'is. Ba'is is the one who look very poor, the one you can understand that he's very poor and he's needy. He doesn't ask you, but you look the way he dressed, the way he talked, the way he lived, you find him like that. And Ba'is is the one who got dhilla, the one who got a very difficult situation in his job. For example, you find Alim, who Hafiz al-Quran, is doing a very humble job, does not suit his knowledge and his job. I know working is an ibadah and it's halal, but we cannot accept a alim, the one who carried the words of Allah, the one who's supposed to be Imamul Muslimin. He's washing the car of a kuffar, the one who does not believe in Allah and his Rasul. I know it's halal work, but that is dhilla. That is dhilla is not for the Muslim at all. And we find plenty Muslim. They made sabr for that job because they want to eat halal, don't want to steal, they don't want to make any haram, they want to ask. So we have to go and assess that ba'is, the one who have that zilla, or the one who is in that shameful situation. And we got plenty people like that. Alim, salih person, working on a bad places, or someone who's shouting him and disgrace him every day. That one, yeah, we have to assist him the greatest sadaqah. And we got plenty Muslim like that. We got plenty people who got knowledge of Allah. Their places is not dead. Their places is a member of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they do that because they don't want to do haram. They don't want to gain income haram and don't want to feed their children haram. The other group of people needs our help. They call them a danka. That's danka. That type of life, a person who is poor, but he got one of his family, or at work, gave him a lot of headache and trouble. A salih man working, he got a terrible wife. Terrible wife, she misused that amanat, she spent it in a terrible way. So that type of people, we have to go and assist him, because he got a terrible person in his life, as the ulama said now. He got son, he got father, he got someone who just suck his blood. So you find some people like that. His wife is irritating him, his manager is irritating him. Stress with poverty. Short money, few amount of money, but also you find a wife, she's fighting with him, troubling him, his son on the drugs and all that. This type of people, they say ma'ishatan danka, they have a very difficult in their life. We have to go and assess them and make it easy for them and lighten. Because poverty with the stress, poverty with sadness is a musiba. That's why they call them danka. Or some rich person, but his children deprive him from his money. As they say, oh, he can't get his money. We have to go and assess these people. We got something, it's called ad-durr. What is ad-durr, brother and sister in Islam? Poverty plus sickness. And now we have to stop and talk about this one here. Poverty with disability. Someone is poor and he's blind. Someone is poor but he got a terrible sickness. Very serious condition. From where you're going to buy medicine? From where you're going to have a happy time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised those who do not look after this type of people azab in dunya and in qabr in akhirah. Do you know any person who's ill, sick, and he doesn't have any means to buy medicine or to eat, because some ill people and sick people, they got special food and very expensive food and they need a special care. And you said, no, he must go to the public hospital and government must feed him and look after him. Brother and sister in Islam, that is a durr. Poverty with disability, poverty with illness and sickness. That one year, I think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish every wealthy person in this dunya because they don't look at this one. They want the people to stand by their door and beg them and cry. They give the liar, but they don't give those who needs that type of help, those who are on durr. Like Nabi Ayyub alayhi salam. Nabi Ayyub alayhi salam left everything, lost everything, and he also got a terrible disease. Rabbi anni massani durr. That is called durr. Brother and sister in Islam, we have to dig down and find who are in durr, because definitely all of us, we fall under this mistake, which we do not look after the sick person, because Allah is there, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question us in the day of Qiyamah about those who are having that dur or that calamity in their body. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talk about takaful, cooperation, assisting one another, is not accepted at all when we find a Muslim people are walking on the street begging. Come to Africa and see. Go to Asia and see, on Kashmir, on Afghanistan, on Palestine, and you find the Muslimin are dying because of hunger, dying. They need a shelter. They need a blanket, and we are enjoying our life. That is unaccepted at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deprive us from His mercy in dunya and akhirah. We don't want to feed the stomach of the people. We have to give them that zakat and sadaqat in a beautiful way. وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ مَعْلُومٌ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. It's his right. So we tell the poor person, take your money. Don't feel shy, because Allah is the one who giving you, not that person. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you as a wajib and a duty for the rich person. He must go and dig down and find and give you your haqq. Raise your head up. It is your money. Take it, and you have to say alhamdulillah. Brother and sister in Islam, if we don't do that, if you don't do that, and you receive the bounty of Allah and the ni'mat of Allah, and you don't give it, as the ulama said, you are halik, you are perished. You already under the trap of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, the ulama said, you are majnoon, you are insane, you lost your mind, because you're sending yourself to azab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the grave with the shuja'ul aqra, as they said, and that money and that curse, it will be curse on you in the qabr in the day of qiyamah. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min malin. Oh Allah, I seek protection in you from a wealth, money. يَتَمَتَّعُ بِهِ غَيْرِي. Someone else will enjoy it after my death. وَيَكُونُ عَلَيَّ وَبَالًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And it will be a curse on me in the day of Qiyamah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Deenul Islam gave Sharia how to make money and how to spend the money and what is the right of this money. And Deenul Islam gave the Sharia to the rich, and he gave to the poor people, do not make business with your poverty. Do not complain Allah. Try to find the work. Try to receive that zakat or that sadaqat with honor. Because amongst the people who hate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hate the most, is those who al-faqir al-mutakabbir. Or faqir dhu iyalin mutakabbir. What is faqir mutakabbir? We find some poor people, they enjoy begging. In the day of Qiyamah, as Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib said, in the day of Qiyamah, they will never have a piece of flesh on their face. They will be a skeleton. Why? Because they beg. We beg the mercy of Allah. We beg the rahmat of Allah. We beg the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we said to the Muslim brother and sister in Islam, don't let the people come to you and beg. How? Run to them before they come to beg. One alim, someone came to his house and asked him, please give me. And he found him. He was very good man. He's not a beggar. But he came and asked. So that alim, he gave him the money, and that man went away. So that alim started to cry and cry and weeping in his room. So his wife said, no, you mustn't cry. You have to thank Allah. You gave him. He said, no, I'm crying because I already gained one beggar extra. I should go to him before he come to me. Brother and sister in Islam, why the beggar come again and again? Because we are stingy. We are very dry, very hard. That's why we don't want to let them understand that they must wait at home till I give them. And we don't visit them. We don't give them. That's why they came to us. Brother and sister in Islam, Muslim is not a beggar. Islam came and gave honor to everyone, even those who take zakat and sadaqat. ذهب الذين يعاش في أكنافهم وبقيت في خلف كجلد الأجرب. Those, our forefather, our great ulama, and those in the golden time of Islam, people, they don't come to them. They go to them. The rich people go to the poor people before they come, and they give him as a hadiah. They don't name it as a zakat. They give it a hadiah. Farmers, they give in a time of harvest. Business people, they give. Family. And the worst, beggars, when the brother beg from his own brother. Muslim, beg from the Muslim, we have to run. People come to our masajid and stand by the door. They don't read salah, but they want to fill the stomach first. Brothers and sisters in Islam, zakat and sadaqat is a very serious issue, very dangerous issue, and we have to teach one another, and we have to encourage one another that we have to feed and give the needy. That is the main message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam came with rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided every Muslim rizq, but because of some problem, because of some test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of the stinginess. Those who are stingy, they will never enter Jannah. Why? Because they deprive the poor person from the haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rich man, you have the ni'mat of Allah. Poor man, you have Allah with you. So don't leave Allah and go for the ni'mah. Brother and sister in Islam, when we talk about rich people, we have to say it now that alhamdulillah, the majority of our wealthy brother, rich brother, they gave zakat. From where our masajid are running, from where our madaris are running, from where the assist of the Muslimin, they don't stand by the door of non-Muslim. Beggars, they come to the Muslim because we do have that heart and we mind the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the love of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Imam al-Fuqara'i wal-Masakin. Indeed, he is the leader of the poor and the needy, and all the Anbiya, the needy and the poor, do follow Anbiya because of that rahmat of Allah and the mercy of Allah and the rizq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, be the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are rich, remember that is amanat in your hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask about it in the day of Qiyamah. And poor man is not calamity, is not shame, because poverty is not shame. You did eat more than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are wearing clothes more than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Your house is better than the rooms of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Your Nabi did not leave one single dinar or dirham for his family, but he left for us Deenul Islam. He left for us a proper wealth. Is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. He left for us the treasure of salah, the treasure of the kalima shahada La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in Quran Kareem, فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمَنُ وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا كَلَّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when we give the bounty of the mankind, you say, oh, Allah has honored me. And when we deprive the mankind from that bounty, he said, Allah did shame me, did have anger on me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, not at all. Not the rich like that, not the poor like that, is a test. Ibtalahu, test. So I don't know who. Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu said, poverty and rich, it's in the day of Qiyamah only. We will know who's poor and rich in the day of Qiyamah. Why? Because yeah, it's an amanat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If that rich person got money and he did not think is a test of Allah and ibtila of Allah, as Sayyidina al-Hasan said, he's majnoon, he's mad. And if the poor person does not believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is testing him and he did not think like that, he's majnoon. So we don't want to be majnoon. We had to have our aql back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften the heart of the rich people to spend the amanat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant the poor people sabr and ajr. They will be the king of Jannah, inshallah. Brother and sister in Islam, unfortunately our time is up. Wait for me, inshallah, next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
La ilaha illallah. إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.